Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. Now the problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the first official SAT study guide for the new SAT exam just released by College Board. As you've heard probably, the new SAT exam will start from March of 2016, so you've got approximately 6 months to go until the first issue of the exam, of the new exam. Okay, so this problem is taken from the first exam, the first practice test in the official new SAT study guide, practice exam number 1, problem number 7 in section 3, where no calculator is allowed. Okay, so this problem tests your understanding of algebra and tests your ability to manipulate, right, this expression properly in order to arrive at the correct solution. And the correct solution will be requiring you to express p in terms of n, r, and m. So you have four variables, right? You have m, you have n, you have p, and you have r. So you have four variables, and right now you're given the expression providing m in terms of n, r, and p, and you're asked to rewrite this equation so that p is going to be in place of m, so that p will be expressed in terms of m, r, and n. Right? So how do we do that? The first thing we need to do, so first notice that p is listed here separately, but algebraically what this means is that p is multiplying the numerator. So basically p is part of the product in the numerator of this fraction, okay? But they're providing it to you separately so that you could understand that p is kind of separate, because you will express p separately. So you could put it kind of in between, but it's really part of the numerator of the fraction here, right? So the first thing that you need to do, you need to get rid of this fraction. So you need to have only the numerator, which includes the p, to be by itself, right? So you need to make sure that this denominator turns to 1. And how do you do that? You do that by multiplying this fraction by the denominator, right? So if you multiply this whole fraction by the denominator, which is 1 plus r over 1200 to the power of n minus 1, so if you multiply this whole fraction by the denominator, you will have 1 in here, right? So you will have the numerator divided by 1. But when you multiply one side of the equation, or divide it, whatever, or minus or plus it, you have to do the same thing to the other side of the equation. So if you multiply this whole fraction by the denominator, you will have to multiply m by the denominator as well. So let's look let's see what the result is. So the result will be that the left side will have m multiplying this denominator, this quantity, and the right side will simply be the numerator with the p multiplied to it, right? So let's see if this first step, if we see this first step expressed in the answer choices provided, right? So we need to find m multiplying this quantity here in the denominator. So let's see. So we have m here for choice A, we have m, and we have 1 plus r over 1200 to the n. But guess what? Where is the minus 1 here? I don't see the minus 1 multiplied to the m here, right? So that means this is no good. We can already cross it out. Now what about choice, answer choice B? So answer choice B sounds more promising to me, because look, we have the m, which is part of the numerator, being multiplied by 1 plus r over 1200 to the power of n minus 1. So the minus 1 is already listed here, and this whole thing multiplies m. And that's exactly what should happen, right? Because if we multiply this fraction by the denominator, we will have to multiply m with the same denominator. And this product is expressed here because m multiplies that denominator, which turns into a numerator here, by the way, right? But in any case, so the first step looks very promising here. The first step is satisfied. Now what about the second step? The second step is that once we have this denominator multiplying m, and we don't have a fraction anymore, we have on the right side p times this thing and times that thing, we have to divide the right side, the resulting right side, by this product of these two expressions, right? So let's find that. Let's find that. So P will be equal to M times this denominator, because we got rid of it, and will be divided by this numerator, because we needed to have P by itself, right? Because this is what the question asks. Express P in terms of M, R, and N. So we need to isolate it. So we will have to divide the left side, which will be M times this denominator here, by the numerator. So let's find this numerator in the denominator. Is it listed? Bingo! In answer choice B, this numerator is the denominator. So as a result, P is expressed correctly, which is 1 plus R over 1200 raised to the n minus 1 divided by R over 1200 times 1 plus R over 1200 raised to the nth power. Okay? So this is how it works. And if you check the answer choices, the other answer choices, this doesn't make sense whatsoever. Where are all the numbers? This is missing a great chunk of information here, right? Choice C and D. But A is almost correct, except that there's no negative 1 on the top. The negative 1 should have been on the bottom, right? It looks like they're kind of messed up. They're trying to trick you by keeping the denominator as the denominator, when in fact it should become the numerator, right, which is here, and the numerator of the original equation must become the denominator of the resulting equation, because we're going to be isolating P, right? So feel free to go back in this video to watch this over again, to follow my steps if you've missed them. So I hope that you found this information useful. Again, this is practice exam number 1, section 3, problem number 7 in the new official SAT study guide just released by College Board. Okay? So I hope that once again this information, this video was useful to you in solving this particular example. Please visit my website, revisedsat.com, very easy to remember, revisedsat.com. This is a website that was created by me. I'm a professional mathematician, professional tutor with over 15 years of experience. I teach levels up to calculus, okay? So feel free to visit the site. There are lots of information on the tutoring.